Hello everyone. In this lesson, we're about to learn how can use or define a workflow or function to interpret a well. We're going to study this example. This is a gas reservoir for which we're going to compute porosity with five different techniques. This particular example is provided in the Learn set of GeolOil. That is an optional set of examples you can acquire for an affordable price. Okay, so the workflow for this well in the website is this one. This is the sequence of function for that. We start computing temperature, then formation water resistivity. This one depends both upon temperature and formation water salinity. Mod filtrate resistivity at borehole temperature. And then as a series of computation, index of gamma ray, B-shell, many other stuff. Okay, so we're going to learn how to do this with a practical example. Okay, when you open GeolOil, you open that example that is provided in the Learn set. You don't have to have the Learn set. This is an example. Those are a collection of nine examples that we advise to acquire. They are affordable. Okay, so you open this, basically file, GLog, something like that. And this is the one. Okay, you open this. It's already open. So we're going to use this. You go to display. And this is the one. Okay, let's see the function. This is the functions. Good. So we're going to see how it works by opening a bare template. A raw alias file from that particular well. Okay, this is the bare LES file. So we have a collection of information, of curves. So what we're going to do is to replicate here more or less most of the function here so you see how it works. This is the way. So you open the GLog example in the Learn set. So we start with temperature function. Okay, so we are going to see how can we replicate this collection of functions into the real example file. So you go function workflow, and we start to define functions. And the sequence of functions will define your workflow. Okay, let's start with temperature. So let's see that my first function is temperature. You click here, the function title, temperature. Assign a color where I want to be this active. This color is this one, pure red, for instance. This is borehole temperature. Now you hit open. As a reference, let's open the example here to the right. You hit open here, and you have to input basic data. You can write some comments here. Okay, let's start with the mnemonic. I want the mnemonic output for that curve to be temperature. Units Fahrenheit. Description, borehole temperature. Okay, you see the horizontal curve will be stored in nothing because we haven't run any function yet. After you run, you will have something like this. So these are the functions you can select and you can define yourself with scripting. So you go to the sample, we go to resistivity. We have 12, the number 12 was selected. Resistivity, and we have several options here. Let's go to the function 12. Okay, so you have to define what is the surface, annual average of surface temperature. You have to get the bottom hole temperature of your well. This comes usually in the blueprints of your logs. At what true vertical depths was taken that measurement? Okay, so go to this example and put your real data. Okay, let's suppose this well is in Wyoming. Let me show you. You click on well path. As long as you put the latitude and longitude, you click on Google Map. Well, you see that the well is non-vertical because the inclination column and it's 6.4 degrees. It's slanted. You hit on Google Maps. It will show you well. You hit satellite view, and you will see physically where your well is. This is a good approximation where's your well. This is your well. That is your well. Here is the Wyoming and Utah border. There is your well. So you have to specify your data. So more or less in Wyoming, the surface temperature is 42. You have to type 42. These are the four, but you have to override your defaults. So for this particular well, at a true vertical depth of 9540, you have a temperature of 144 Fahrenheit. There is something you have to specify. What is the curve number of the true vertical depths? Let's check. Okay, in this example, it is the curve number 2. Okay, if you don't have that curve, you can ask your GeolOil to compute that curve. So you go to, let me see this one, AppDVDM subsea curves, and it will compute those for you, as long as you have the deviation survey well path. It's here. Okay, so it was already computed, so we can remove that. We can remove that. Okay, so we have to tell GeolOil that true vertical depth is the curve number 2. So you go here and specify 2. Okay, this is your input. You need the annual temperature average at surface. It's cold, Wyoming is cold. The bottom hole temperature and the bottom hole depths in true vertical depths and the core number for that. You see if the output is still, the core number is 0. And we don't have yet any temperature. So you simply calculate this and see what happens. Okay, you go to curves, and here is your temperature. Let's have a look. You hit on edit table. Okay, here are your temperatures. Okay. These are the temperatures. Okay, so we have computed the borehole temperatures. Okay, now go to the next function. Okay, you go to the function of workflow. So the next function is RW. RW. That is formation water resistivity. We need that. We need that to compute water saturation at some point later on. Water saturation later on, something like, okay, water saturation here, final water saturation, etc. it uses formation water resistivity. So we need RW, so you append a new function on the workflow and call it as you want, maybe RW. Put the same red color and write formation water resistivity. Formation water resistivity. Okay, for this particular formation water resistivity, for this particular formation, we know for ionic water analysis on other ways that the salinity is around, again replicating this value here, is around 33.7 kppm of sodium chloride. Now you have to fit the data inside. So let's go to the example. Okay, let's open this. Go click on open. Okay, the mnemonic for my curve will be RW. The units will be on meters. And description, the short formation water resistivity. Formation water resistivity. Okay, still zero, there is no output yet. So we have to go to resistivity and temperature. So we are going to use the equation 8. You have many choices. So here we see the equation 8. Okay, so we need for this one, we are converting salinity to formation water resistivity RW. So we need the reservoir temperature. We already computed that. It's here, for 79. Or one easy way is to hover the mouse here, and you see 79, the function 45. Okay, so the curve number is 79. So you can have the reservoir temperature can be a constant. Really is normally a curve number, should be 79. You verify this, and you have to input the salinity. As I told you, the salinity for this reservoir, it is this one. This one you may copy, paste this value, and so far it's a constant, but you can have a well with crosses over for formation. If formation have a different salinity, you will need to compute this. We have some examples of that. In the learn set, there are some examples of that. So we have the reservoir temperature and the salinity, and we compute the curve for that. Let's hit calculate. And it's coming. Output. Okay, it created the curve in the number 80. The curve number 80. You see here? That's your curve. Let's see how it looks together with temperature. Temperature and RW. Okay, you hit edit table, and there are the two. So you see the RW is not constant. This is because the temperature gets hotter and hotter as the well deepens. So it is not constant. As you go, the temperature increases, RW decreases, more bluish, and so forth. This is the way it works. Function workflow, and that's it. So you compute, you define a function, you put the parameters, you take care of the boxes. Some boxes are values, in other cases they are curves itself. You run that, then you have an output curve number. The output curve number is written here, is produced here. The output curve is produced here. Then you have a curve. Then you go to the next function. This function, logically, is after the temperature. Formation water resistivity depends upon temperature. It's the number 8. 79 was the former already computed curve, and you specify the salinity. So this is where the functions are changed. Once you master it, it's not very difficult to do that, to understand that. You can make a modification here, a parameter here, anywhere in your workflow. I don't know, maybe put 60 instead of 42, whatever you need. Make a modification. Now you want to update the whole curves. You run the checked functions in sequence, and you have updated your model. That's it. Okay, thank you very much. This is the basics. Please enter for your example, follow the learn set, or there are some examples that are built in with the basic license. Thank you very much. Have a very nice rest of the day. Goodbye.